Hello, basketball fans. Great matchup for you tonight between the Wisconsin Badgers and the Indiana Hoosiers. Number 20 is a primetime player who's going to be depended on for a big game in tonight's contest.
This youngster is an offensive machine. He's got a nice jumper and isn't afraid to go hard to the rack.
The Hoosiers will see that their offense goes through him tonight, Dick. The Hoosiers should be able to put this team away early, Dick. What's the key to them doing that tonight?
Hey, Brad, for them tonight, the keys are as follows. Number one, play it your style. Don't get roped into doing things that you normally don't do. You must be in control. Secondly, hand the ball down low for some easy baskets. It'll be a bonus if we can get their big man in foul trouble. Lastly, take care of the ball on offense and play aggressive perimeter defense.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. He gets the bucket.
You're going to be seeing this one all week.
On the dribble, gives it up for two. Perfectly executed.
Look at that. That's unbelievable, baby.
Both teams looking to get things going here. And the fans are going wild.
Wow, the energy in here is electrifying.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Way out on top, controlling the ball.
You are being used as a launching pad.
The low block. Trying to stay with him defensively, and he's going to pick up the foul.
Oh, what a terrific job exploding to the basket. Poor job defensively letting him get the ball that deep.
Working it around the perimeter. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
Here's the offensive drop step, the low block, but better defense.
I'll tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
On the outside, Lawson handles the feed, scorches the net.
Roll it back, fellas. Get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. There's a double team waiting there. Sinks it. Hobbs is feeling good.
Hey, can you blame him, Brad? He's getting it done.
Gave it up. The center receives the ball and off the mark. He keeps the dribble as they reset.
Up and inside.
He shoots from downtown. They're nailing three balls at will right now.
They're really hurting them with the three-point shooting.
Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
He'll regroup the offense. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
That's an 8-zip run.
On the dribble, gives it up.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Lawson receives the pass. Count that as a personal foul. Oh, and you talk about a happy group of fans. Listen to this crowd.
Oh, there's all kinds of people standing and cheering and going wacky.
From downtown, makes the shot. Robs him of the ball. Here they come now on a turnover.
Good athletic move. Very athletic. He's got great
Shows patience waiting for the reset. Picks off the lazy pass. Gave it up. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity. And it really converts an offensive transition.
Ball was knocked loose, but the offense got it back. For the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Trying to pack it inside. Intercepted. Inside. I think that's why college basketball has the following it does, Dick. People from all over town and throughout the campus come and enjoy themselves at these games.
Wow, the energy is unbelievable in here.
Lawson handles the pass. He drains it. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. I think they're trying to make a statement. Full house and a packed crowd, and they are into it tonight.
I tell you, what emotion, what an edge for the home team.
On the outside. Goes up for two. Perfectly executed. Inside.
Double team now, bad angle.
There's a bad pass right to the defender. And the ball goes out of play. Here's a flash from the high post. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up to get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass. Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
They get the ball down low, and he hips up with his man, and down he goes.
Hey, Brad, that's a flop. That's Mr. Flop right there. Don't call that, baby.
Stolen away. They run it up into transition. Looking for the foul. He puts it in with contact and all. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. He tries for two and in and out. It up. Defender knocked the ball loose, but the offense got it back. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
10 seconds showing on the shot clock. Takes the pass in the paint. Drops the bucket despite the harm.
Let's take another look.
Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
Here they come with a double team to stop it. Let's it fly. You betcha.
Let's go to the instant replay camera.
Gave it up. He went for the steal in the post, and he missed it, Dick.
Oh, I'll tell you one thing. What a poor job defensively. He gambled.
Problem with that, when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play on there and you're fronting.
puts it up looking for contact.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. And up. The Badgers have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding them the ball. It's simple.
At a momentary look from three-point land. Here's a double team. Puts it up. Way off target. He beats him to the punch defensively. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Gets it back out. Tries one from three-point land. Buried it. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Offense gets it back after that ball was knocked loose. The center in the paint. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
The student section is all rallied up, and they are ready to battle.
They're rocking right now. My goodness.
For two. The Hoosiers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
Daddy's on fire.
This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. Some people's, he takes the hard hack in the air, but he lays the ball in.
That's what you take for the team, Brad.
Look at him now, Dick, celebrating with the cheerleaders. Now, that's a spectacle.
I love the zest of the young man. Dancing with the cheerleaders, that's awesome, Brad.
So he'll get an opportunity to change the scoreboard again from the free throw line.
Well, he created a foul opportunity.
Spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? For the bucket. Easy one.
That's a nice simple run.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish close position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
Gave it up. Steals a pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. There's the pick. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Around the arc. Harm and foul. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Guys, both the players and coaches seem really confused right now around the benches. Again, the focus seems to be getting their number one guy going. They haven't been able to do anything without him tonight. We're going to have to keep an eye on him.
Ball was tipped loose, but the offense retains possession. He shoots from the top of the key. Defensively down to the low block, and there's a steal.
A terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
For two, they're lighting it up from the field right now, Dick.
They're in a dangerous rhythm, my friend.
Dangerous?
Dangerous for the defense if they keep it up.
Trying to draw some contact. Sinks the shot. Good job defensively. Indiana are on a run right here as of late, Dick.
Yeah, they're starting to put it together on offense. Can they keep it together, though? That is the question.
How can you not love this game and the hoopla and fanfare that goes along with it?
The mayhem is off the charts, Brad.
Almost lost the basketball. There's a high screen. Up fake. That has some folks out of their seats.
Hey, that reaction says it all. These fans are ecstatic, Brad.
For the bucket. He hits a bullseye again.
Hey, he's feeling it from everywhere, baby.
He up fakes. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And drains the shot. Boy, terrible execution on offense. Goes up for two. Up, easy one.
Look at that spacing.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Oh, the cheerleaders into it big time for their team.
They are really involved. I'll tell you one thing, they bring a lot of spirit.
He shoots from the elbow. Gets it to fall.
Let's see that up close.
Defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off. I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
Jumps into the defender. Basket falls despite the contact. This place will be in complete chaos if this defense can get a stop right here. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
On the dribble, gives it up. Obvious foul. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
He'll go to the line. He missed it. He gets the board.
They say forget about it, and then he does a little dribbling act here and turns it over.
Off the rim and no good. The Hoosiers have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
They work it around the perimeter. On the inside. Leans in. That was nice.
We gotta roll that one back.
He intercepts it. Gave it up. Here's the three ball. Nice shot.
Let's slow this one down on a replay.
Let's watch the move as he works his man and on a fadeaway jumper. And he scores despite the hack. Fans, they're loving it.
I'll tell you, Brad, those schools with the best home records probably have incredible school pride. They don't call it the six-man for no reason.
There was no doubt about that one. They're working around the perimeter. Low block.
There's the trap.
From the top of the circle.
Big-time shot right there. I'll tell you, big time look.
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
There's a double team waiting there. Entry pass in the paint. Steals the ball. There they are on the low block on the move inside, and the big guy picks up the foul.
Hey, Brad, you can't allow a guy to get the ball in that deep, and he does a great job putting it to the deck and attacking the basket.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
He makes a nice shot fake. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
The skip pass is picked off. Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
For the bucket, this team right now just lighting it up from everywhere.
Hey, they're finding each other in rhythm with their passing, Brad. That makes a huge difference in how shooters shoot.
In the paint. He wants a three. Got it. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
That spin move's not going to work against the defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin. Keep your eye right on the ball here. Opportunity for 2-for-1.
Job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in a basketball.
Picked off. Shot clock is dead. Tickles a twine.
Got to think right now. Got to focus defensively.
He makes a good move using the pro hop and draws the foul. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
He steps up to the line. Makes his first. second.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
At the end of the first half, the Hoosiers are down by 8. Thus far, it's been a tightly contested game. Dick, what's your highlight of the first half?
No bigger shot in the first half for me than this three ball from downtown, baby. Teams build the confidence they need when the threes are falling.
And now let's get ready for the start of the second half. Indiana has turned the ball over a lot more than normal in that first half.
They're very sloppy in moving the ball tonight. And as a result, turnovers are piling up like dirty laundry.
Second half, Dick, our focus player update. And what's he got to focus on, or what do his teammates have to focus on?
Well, I think he's got to attack the basket a lot more. I think he's got to get opportunities to go to the free throw line. And that'll come if he becomes aggressive.
Goes up for two. And he missed. Looking for contact. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score.
Up and inside.
Leaning in, trying to draw contact. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
Gets a hand in the way. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
And he'll kick it back outside. The ball goes out of play. You start comparing these backcourts, Dick. What are your impressions so far?
You know, well, for me, Brad, good guard play will take you a long ways. If you think about teams in the past, they all had...
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely.
The ball goes out of bounds. And this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas.
And the ball goes out of play. Oh, and you talk about a happy group of fans. Listen to this crowd.
Oh, there's all kinds of people standing and cheering and going wacky.
Way off target. Picked out of the air. Work it inside, and he tries a drop step. Defensively, nice job.
Great job using his footwork defensively to beat him to the spot.
Stolen away. It's a fast break possibility.
Nice high post screen.
They are heating up this building with their shooting right now, Dick.
The hits just keep coming, baby.
On the inside. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
He looks for the bomb. It sticks. For two. Doesn't go. Jumps in.
Look at that drive.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. Little Baryshnikov right there. You always were a dancer. Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
For the bucket.
He kept his dribble and ran the defender right off the screen for a beautiful jump shot, Brad.
They come with a double team to stop it.
They strip him of the basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post-play because they were really anticipating the spin.
The Hoosiers have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Daddy's on fire.
Takes the pass in the paint, trying to draw the foul. He puts it in with contact and all. Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Goes up for two. They work the perimeter. Looking for the foul. Up. Easy one.
Number 45.
Up and inside.
Here's a double team. Pump fakes. He shoots from left of the circle.
I need to see that again, Brad.
He shoots. Off the rim and no good. Oh, and you can tell by the look on his face, he wasn't expecting the whistle on him.
Wow, look at the facial expression. He says, me? I like it when a team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
Misses the second shot. He takes the board. Pass down low. There's a drop step. And, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow. Soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively.
Get that sucker out of the game, man.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
The student body looks to be full with rage and willing to cheer on the old home team.
The student section looks like they're having a great time.
On the outside. And now they'll bring it up. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
He shoots from the top of the key. Drains it. Tries to get the D to bite. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
How about a replay, boys?
On the dribble, gives it up. Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Puts it up, looking for contact. Drops the bucket despite the harm. He shoots from the top of the key. The shot won't fall. Now they work it around the perimeter. Way out on top, controlling the ball, makes the shot. And all the way on the baseline, now the kick out. Looks at a three, sinks the shot.
They scored seven in a row.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Tries for two. Basket falls despite the contact. Fakes a jumper. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
The momentum is on their side. High fives, chest bumps. We're seeing it all now.
They're definitely having some fun out there.
High post flasher is open.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
Spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
The ball goes out of play. Those are the types of plays you want a lot of. These kids are on a roll. Look at them celebrating with one another.
I celebrate too, partner. They are playing some great basketball at the moment.
For two, perfectly executed. That's going to be an offensive foul for sure.
What a great job defensively. What a super job. Great footwork. And he really draws the charge.
Entry pass in the paint. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
For the bucket.
I tell you, great job protecting the basketball, getting deep post position, and the jump hook is so effective.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
Tell you,
and they're going to count it.
Determination, baby.
Nelson steps to the line for the first time. He gets it to go. Dick, when I see those types of things, I just get chills.
Oh, I couldn't agree with you more, Mr. Nessler. We are so lucky that we get to go to all these schools and experience the mayhem firsthand.
Takes away the pass. With a deep pass. Goes up for two. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
The Hoosiers have a number of seniors in their lineup. That factor alone will definitely help their cause. Moving it around the perimeter. Looking for a good shot. Tries for two. He hits the shot. Gave it up. Looks at the three. Makes the shot. Time to pick up the defense here now. There's the fake. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
For two, Indiana have put together somewhat of a run here.
Maintaining it is the key, though. They've got to continue to make the hustle plays at both ends of the court.
The Badgers have a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. The ball goes out of bounds. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad, before the game, the coaching staff told me they worried this situation could happen. They told me it's so important for the supporting cast to get involved and not rely on one player. Right now, the coaches are trying to get everyone on the bench on the same page, guys.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, guys, the battle in the paint has played a major factor in this game and is probably some of the reason why they have this lead. If things don't change in a hurry, this game could get ugly, guys.
I think she's right about that, Richie.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down in the post is where you create a lot of offensive action.
Nice little jam right there, the one-hand jam and stuff. Little showtime, little pizzazz. Get out the mustard.
Here's a spin down to the low block.
I think he's got a variety of moves. Use the sky hook, the jump hook, and now a spin move to the goal.
An open look if he wants it. Lets it fly. Buried it. Got a nice screen. They work it around the perimeter.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball in the deck. Where's he going?
Tries a three. Dick, they are loving it behind that line.
Hey, as long as you're hitting, the loving is good, baby. The defender's doing a great job of applying ball pressure.
Goes in. Off the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. Buries it home. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Gant receives the ball. The ending to this one might be headline news in tomorrow's paper.
At this point in the game, clock management and execution are really important. The team that does these things well will win, I guarantee it.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
They work the perimeter. The post flashes up high if he wants it. Robs him of the ball. For that reason, right there, that's why I love college basketball.
The Rutgers fans are going nuts. They're going bananas, Brad.
Spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Taken away. Here we go on the break. Dick, they're ripping up the nets tonight.
Hey, they're definitely shooting the ball well tonight. Great execution by these boys.
He goes for the trifecta. He gets the bucket.
We need an instant replay for this one.
If they can get a score, this place is going to go wild. A high screen. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
For two.
I didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn.
The power forward handles the pass. Steals the ball. Dick, this crowd will go silly if they can get some points this trip. And he'll kick it back outside. Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
On the outside. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
He shoots. Off the rim and no good. Looking for a good shot. Gave it up. Puts it up. He drains the shot. The center handles the feed. Defensively trying to stay with his man, and he's going to pick up a foul.
What a poor job defensively. Very slow inside, and they attack him aggressively.
High post flashes for the opportunity. Dumps it in. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up. You get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
They just can't seem to miss.
They found a serious stroke with their shooting, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up.
Double team now, bad angle.
He goes with a jump hook. The Hoosiers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Working it around the perimeter.
Steele, go up the other way. Get a layup.
Gave it up. He'll go to the line after that vicious dunk, Dick.
Vicious is right, Brad. That dunk brought me right out of my seat, baby.
Now look at him celebrating with the cheerleaders of all people.
Hey, he's dancing, baby. A dancer. I never knew that. I'm surprised.
Number 34 set to record his first action.
Hey, this guy will give you a great hustle on a defensive end of the floor.
He goes to the line, shooting one. No doubt about it. The students are all fired up and ready to do whatever's necessary to help their team win.
The student body looks like they're ready to terrorize the opposition.
Defensively, and this is going to be an Academy Award, Dick.
Absolutely, Academy Award at its best.
Picked out of the air. Pushes it. Picked off. Comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
It drops. He came up with a layup after he was fouled in the air.
He deserves a standing O for that one. That was beautiful.
Number 45 subs back into the thick of things, Dick.
Hey, you can't keep a guy like this out for too long, Brad. He's just too valuable.
Sinks it. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Timeout on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game. That makes it a four-point lead.
These kids are here to fight, Brad.
Great defense. The shooting guard gets the pass. Steals the pass. Goes up for two.
Foul them early and give your team a chance.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. And there's a look at the foul situation so far.
Hey, know when to foul and when not to foul is a great skill to have. Coaches should always be communicating this with their team.
Dick, let's take a look right now at our backcourt production.
Hey, team success depends on backcourt production, Brad. If you can handle the rock, make good decisions, penetrate, and knock down the open jumper, you give yourself a great opportunity to get to the winner's circle.
At the line. Makes the front end of the 1-1. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
Buries it.
This is where you really need a bucket to have a chance. We've got ourselves a dandy here, folks.
The lead has been trimmed to four. Strips the ball. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. There's a look at the timeout situation.
Hey, some people like to call it game management, Brad. Knowing when to use timeouts is an art. Also, team fouls. Defending without fouling is always important.
They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Second one, good.
They really need a score here to turn this into a two-possession game.
They've changed things up a little bit, Dick.
We'll see what they come up with, Brad.
He takes the three. He buries it. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. Points off turnovers, Dick. A stat I know coaches pay a lot of attention to.
Hey, Brad, it sure is. You want to limit your opponent's number of points off turnovers. Ultimately, you want to nullify the easy basket.
Second. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day. It'll be interesting to see who responds how out of the timeout, Brad.
He unloads a three. Oh, yes! And yet another foul. Well, here's a look at the turnover situation, Dick. Probably one of the stats that coaches really care about the most.
I'll tell you, definitely, Brad. Turnovers are missed shot opportunities. And without shot opportunities, winning games becomes really difficult.
No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
Hits that one. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
ready to start again. Our focus player update, our final one of the ball game, and he led his team to victory.
I tell you one thing, he really responded to the challenge, and that led them to the winner's circle.
Indiana comes away with a win.
They came into favorites, and they did not disappoint.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.